fall camp. And finally here, tired of vacation. We've got 9 good weeks of summer in. Gave the guys a week off last week. They're back, they're eager, they're ready to go. We just had a little run-through pre-practice thing in there, and they weren't supposed to sweat because it was kind of a walk-through, run-through type stuff, and they're all drenched right now. I was trying to trick them by being inside, and then practice was supposed to start here, but they're already tired. So that just means they're eager and they're ready to go. Take a few questions.
Dana, that rule that don't comment, but you can click the social media thing with endorsing recruits and stuff.
Nauseating.
Yeah. You going to leave that up to your guys?
Absolutely nauseating. That's all I want to say about that. I think the NCAA will revisit that. The bottom line is they made it a lot harder to recruit, and they made their life a lot easier. So leave it to the – I probably ought to be careful. But leave it to the NCAA to make it easier on them and harder on us.
Scholarship kids not here?
No, everybody's here ready to go. We got a couple making up a summer workout that they decided to go home before that summer workout was made up. So, which is summer's mandatory. They left early, so they got to make that up before they're privy to go practice. So there's a couple of them out there, but they'll be out here pretty quick.
Every team has a trademark, a tone, something that differentiates it from the last team. You've got a good idea on this. What do you think this team will be, and where does that come from? Does it come from the coach, or does it come from the players?
I think it comes from collectively a lot of different things. It can come from y'all at times. It can come from what people are saying about us. Last year there was a lot of optimism because of what we had coming back defensively. This year there's not quite as much optimism, but we got equally as much coming back offensively. That kind of made us mad offensively last year. It makes us mad defensively this year. So I just think that there's a little bit of a chip on our shoulder. We're anxious to put in the work to get us to that game.
Anybody working in any new positions in the room?
Nah, Johnny Lewis is back at the end. We just need that body. Plus we got Lesko at tight end. We got a couple more tight end bodies, so he'll be back at defense on D line, D end, and then Chase Bernhardt. We're experimenting with him at nose guard. We recruited him as an offensive lineman, but we're thin because Jaleel Fields is out. I don't know if I even mentioned this. He had knee surgery, so he's out for the year. So we're down a body at nose. We're seeing if Chase can do that. He's a Kyle Rose of sorts, high school state wrestling guy. That he's got a mean streak to him. So we'll see if he can do it. We don't know if he can.
And Dana, nausea aside, on the social media thing, do you have a plan for it? You're just letting your guys do whatever they want?
Just do what you want. With the relaxed rules, we're not going to get in trouble. With relaxed rules with phone calls and text messages, we're not going to get in trouble. It's funny how we're on. We had a quote-unquote major infraction with some impermissible text message and phone call, of which no more than one was to a single project, and somehow that's a major infraction, but it's not legal, so I guess we won't get in trouble.
You said that ramping up the pass game is a major priority for you guys this fall camp going into the season. Do you have any specific plan on how you're going to be able to get that going a little bit better?
Already done it. I mean, we did it a lot in spring. We have dang near the same bodies out there right now that we had in spring. Young offensive lineman, which we're probably not going to count on very much. Javon's back. He looks good. He's gonna dabble in some inside receiver today. Tackles with Coach Wickline, it showed a lot of improvement in the spring. The rapport with Skyler and the receivers, I mean, it looks a lot better as well. So just continuing what we did in the spring. Just reps and reps and reps. All those reps should turn out to be beneficial when we need them to.
You
got
to force feed Justin Crawford a lot of reps to sort of see what he can do.
Yeah, oh yeah, he looks good. Thick, quick, twitchy, fast. Was here all summer, so he's ahead of the curve. We don't have to teach him what to do out there. Petaway was not here all summer, so we're going to have to teach him. But we really don't have to teach Justin. He was here all summer. He knows what to do. We'll plug him in there and see what it looks like. like, looks good. Looks good. All right, look good in that run through.
Dana, physically, physically, your receivers probably collectively as good as you've had?
I can't say that. The likes of Justin Blackman, Josh Cooper.
Well, I mean, Cooper, yeah, okay.
Yeah, those, I mean, we go back to Texas Tech, yeah. Welker and Crabtree and Amendola. That's some tough ones. I'm not putting this group in that category yet. I like the physical nature of Dekeel. You know, Gary's got physical nature to him. We got to get Shelton and Karan and a lot of these younger, twitcher guys to see if they can be physical at all.
Here, though? It's not like it's like one
probably,
guy big like Kevin.
Probably.
What is that?
Probably. You know, Kevin was pretty physical. Right. I mean, he could dominate. Mario was soft. I can't wait till that goes viral. Dekeel, Stedman was, that wasn't his strength. I mean, his strength was gliding and just, he had to mesmerize people with how he wiggled. It's got a chance to be here.
Yeah.
It's got a chance to be here.
That makes a difference, what, when it's in the air, off the line, and when it's in their hands?
Blocking, attacking. You got to be physical. If you want to be a big-time receiver, you got to be physical through bodies. A lot of times if you're running a route, you're being defended, those guys knock you off your route, then it's no good. You got to be physical through routes. You got to be physical when you block. You got to be physical when people get up in your face and put their hands on you. So this group's got a chance. By no means are we going to put them in any of the categories that I just said.
What about straight line speed with those guys?
Now that's a different story. Yeah. That's a different story. This is collectively the fastest group. That doesn't mean they're the most productive or effective or any good at all, but collectively it's probably a straight line for the fastest group. Probably ever.
You talk a lot about having experience defensively, just not together. Is there a way to try to work on that, looking at different lineups, anything like that, to see chemistry?
It's what fall camp's all about. Yeah. We're going to line up and go through 29 practices. We'll get 50 snaps a team today and 40 snaps a scale. It's just day one of 29 days to be able to get out there and just play. I mean, you gotta play. You gotta put the ball down. You gotta play.
That's really talking about strength.
Is that really like the heart of the football season? Or and also the two on the offensive side.
Can't answer it defensively, offensively, yeah. I mean, without a doubt. I mean, your center quarterback, which is about as middle as you can get. I mean, those guys got a lot of snaps in the belt. Not teaching them anything. We're playing ball and getting better at practicing and developing relationships and rapport. Having the guards, it gives you a chance to be successful. Now you still gotta have guys that can see the hole. Wendell can hit the hole pretty good. He couldn't get you 12, but he could get you 10 real quick. You got to have those guys, and you got to make plays at receiver. We've talked a lot about having to score more. I mean, we got to have guys that can make people miss and figure out ways to get in the end zone. Without that, being solidified up front, those guys don't have a chance. So it's fun to have an offensive line that gives you a chance to be able to work on the other stuff. And as we all know, that's why it's higher fire.
Georgia Southern Prep was a different animal last year. With Missouri, the opener this year, you get to stayed with fundamentals a little longer in camp before you turn.
Yeah, we start school 2 days later too, for whatever reason, I don't know, but we were working on Georgia Southern throughout 5 weeks of camp. Mm-hmm. We're here, we won't have to work on Missouri until about 2 weeks, 2 weeks before the first game. So it does, it gives us another week and a couple more periods to be able to do that. All right, let's go to work.